One of the most important aspects to consider when beginning your design with 80/20 is your choice of fasteners. In an effort to be able to provide solutions for unique projects, 80/20 offers a wide variety of fastener options. To simplify the decision-making process, we'll break down the fastening methods into two main categories: internal and external fasteners. Internal fasteners are recessed in the T-slot of profiles, and they're easy to assemble. External fasteners are directly mounted to the T-slot, which means they usually don't require machining. Some of our more popular fastening methods include anchor fasteners, end fasteners, and flat plates. As for quick frame and ready tube profiles, they're simply fastened using connecting inserts. Now that we've looked at a brief summary of fastening methods, let's review some considerations to keep in mind. They are load capacity, compatibility, hardware, and profile finish. Let's start with load capacity. It's best to determine load capacity on a case-by-case basis because it may vary depending on how the fastener is used in the project. For example, if your final project needs to hold large amounts of weight and maintain torsion control, anchor fasteners in addition to plates or brackets might be a good option. If you're unsure of the load capacity of your fastener, you can check using the fastening application test on page 62 in the catalog, or contact your 80/20 design specialist. Another component to keep in mind is compatibility. It's important to make sure that the profile you're using is compatible with the fastener you want to use. However, not all fasteners are available for all series profiles. For example, transition plates are currently available for joining 10 to 15 series and 25 to 40 series. If you have a compatibility concern, you can find icons throughout the catalog to identify which series of profiles a product is compatible with. Another important element to consider is the hardware of your chosen fastener. There are three common types of hardware that include drop-in T-nuts that can be loaded from anywhere on the profile, meaning you won't have to undo any progress made during your build if you forget something. Roll-in T-nuts, which load from their side and spin into place, allowing for infinite positioning along the T-slot. And slide-in T-nuts, which load from the end of the profile. When considering hardware, we should also think about hardware installation. When deciding your installation method, it's very important to keep in mind how you plan to assemble your project. Consider when the fasteners will be used and if they need to be preloaded onto the profile before both ends are captivated. For example, if your build is large and complex, it might be easier to use all drop-in T-nuts or even have some extras just in case you need to add something later on in the build process. A final component to keep in mind is profile finish. We offer a wide variety of finishing options. You can even find black anodized flat plates to go with black anodized profiles. However, some fastener methods may work better with one profile finish than others. For example, if you've chosen to use a powder coat finish, it may be better to use an end fastener instead of an anchor fastener in order to ensure easy installation and alignment. Now that we've explored the main considerations to keep in mind when choosing your fasteners, are you ready to start designing? We hope you found this segment on fastener methods helpful. For more information, please visit 8020.net. When you subscribe to our channel, you can expect to see more inspiration for your future projects.